Well, the first time I met Elvis, actually, it was on the Louisiana Hayride. It was late 1954. I wasn't working with him. I was working on the Hayride. And the Louisiana Hayride, of course, everybody knows, was a show now, like the Grand Ole Opry is today. Except that it was a stepping stone. Everybody that was on the Opry later started at the Hayride. Slim Whitman, Jim Reeves, Elvis Presley, and it goes on and on. Nat Stuckey, and it goes on and on with the country artists, Webb Pierce, you know. They were all on that stage at about the same time. In fact, we worked a lot of country shows early. And Elvis was only the only, well, he, I think he called himself country at the time. But he wasn't really a country artist. He wasn't a rock artist. I don't know what the heck you'd call him. He was right in the middle of everybody, you know. He was like a mixture of gospel songs, rockabilly songs. He learned out of Memphis, you know. So they said, we're going to bring this guy in called Elvis Presley. I said, is that his real name? I was talking to the management. They said, well, yeah, that's his real name. I said, well, he might make it with that name or get thrown out of town, you know, one of the two. And they come in, and because I was like playing staff on like a Saturday night hayride, it's all it's one night a week. And Scotty said, you know, you want to do these two or three songs with us? I said, well, yeah. They only had about two or three songs. That's all they knew in the first place. And I said, well, let's go out in the dressing room and talk about it. And just talk about it. And it was Bill Black and Scotty Moore and Elvis. And Elvis played his own rhythm, you know, that rhythm guitar. And he played really good rhythm. And then, of course, Bill was doing a slap bass and Scotty Echoplex guitar. And I sat there and I said, well, man, this sound is so good. Now, why should I go in there and clutter it up? You know, what can I do? Just I'll help, but I don't want to mess with their deal. So I just played a backbeat for him, just real straight ahead, no fills, no nothing. Just, and somehow it worked. And he had tried some other drummers, but he wasn't happy with them. He didn't dislike them, but it just didn't work. And like I say, I just learned to stay out of their way. And that's why it worked, I think.